Anuj and I have been talking for about 2 months to make this happen. I'm really excited that he's here. I've been following his work for the last 1.5 to 2 years. On Aap Daily, I was really excited when I saw on Aap Daily that he's become a partner, like a content partner with Aap Daily. For those who don't know, Aap Daily is the world's largest, most visited architectural website. So for a person from our city, from Pune and Nasik, to have that kind of connection with an international website is wonderful. Apart from that, personally I love his work, the jokes, the sense of humor, and it reminds me of, you know, my time in college and in the profession. And not only that, it's also about really a reflection on life. And that to me is something that really works, where you bring in different elements of design, architecture and life together and like make it funny, you know, and like laugh about it. So I'm a big fan of his work, and I think it's wonderful that he has followed his heart, and he's 28, and he's decided, I think 2 years ago, to do this full time. So he is a full time cartoonist, graphic artist, I would say, and he is, you know, working. He travels around the country giving workshops in different colleges and sharing his work. I don't know how many talks he presents, but we are really happy to have you here. I think this is the first talk in Pune.
Yeah, it's the first.
So we are delighted to have you here. Yeah. Anuj is an architect. He graduated from a college in Pune.
A college in Nasik.
And he also studied urban design at CEPT, and then decided that this is not for him. And he rather joke about the profession, and you know, in a sense, look at it in a different way. I think he's very much an architect and designer from that perspective. So certainly, we'll not. I don't. There's no adverse comment in that sense. So thanks, Anuj, for coming, and looking forward.
So this is, I think, the one of the heaviest intro I've ever got. I'm obliged. This is too much for me, Khushru. This is too much. I'm just trying to enjoy my life, trust me. Okay. And I think whatever I'll talk, instead of me talking to you, I think it is more of a visual narrative which I've prepared. Instead of me telling you about where did I start, like all those things, I think it would be better if I show it to you directly on this thing, because my language is visuals, so I think that's the best way to communicate. So like just before just starting the presentation, anybody who doesn't know about this lever disc thing? Yeah, okay. So have you seen any one of these images somewhere on your WhatsApp group or... Okay, theek hai. So this is basically, people who don't know about lever disc, this was just a overview of the famous comics which might have went viral or might have reached beyond the social media. So these are like, this is a collage of what I do. So the first thing was, apart from me doing architecture, I was always a fan of reading comic books from my childhood. And so this love was so much that, you know, I used to save money and buy comic books when I was like a kid. I always used to love the stories which they used to tell. I know novels also tell a story, but I think for me, the story with the visuals was a, you know, the thing which attracted. And you know, there is always a character, you know, just like a movie. I mean, comic books are, I think, a movie which has been converted into a book. That's what my definition of a comic book is. Because there was always a central character, just like the movies. There is an environment, just like the movies. So I was always fascinated with this one character. I mean, you have never seen these images. Why I showed you, there's a reason why I showed you these five... images. This is one of the reasons I actually started drawing about comics. So this comic is called Scott Pilgrim versus the World. I don't know if you have heard about this name. There's a movie also which had come. So this is one of the few movies where the comic book is converted into a movie. So, you know, this is like one of the inspirations. And in India, if I love comic books, I cannot do anything related to it. I mean, I cannot study comic making, okay? There's no such thing called, you know, learning comics or degree in... Yeah, the closest is, I think, graphic design, okay? But why I chose architecture is because, yeah, my father's an architect. So I think this was the perfect balance between being creative, like in the comic books, and my father also wanting me to become an architect. So I thought it's the best way to come at peace, because I didn't want to, because my father wanted my elder brother to become an architect, but he got into IT. So the only option I had was to choose architecture. But I'm not saying that I did not like it. Yeah, I said ki this was the closest to what I wanted to do. So I could still explore my passion while being in this field. Subconsciously, it was not there written. So the architecture course helped me to visualize my own world. And at the same time helped me look at it critically, because it's not only about visualizing buildings, it's something more than that. But I used to spend a lot of time working on the presentation rather than working on design, I think, which was fine, because I didn't want to build like design buildings. So I was happy presenting my ideas in a different way. So every year I had this thing that I used to finish my work, whatever the design is, and I used to start thinking of how I will present the whole idea. And to some extent, the teachers told me ki, this is not the way of studying in architecture. But I thought, theek hai, I'll do what I feel is good. And then I'm not endorsing SEP, they have not paid me, okay? But I'm seriously very thankful to this institute, because this is where, the school taught me a lot of things. The institute inspired me to think to decide what is right and wrong, rather than telling me ki this is right and wrong. So they taught me in such a way that I could myself decide what is right and wrong. And if you could recognize, if somebody can recognize this, yeah, it's Neelkanth Chaya. So he is one of the guys who had told me that, it's a very small story. When I wanted to do this, I went to Ahmedabad and I told sir, I want to do something on this lines. And he said, you came to SEPT, we put you in a cage. Okay, you adapted to the cage environment, we fed you. And now we have opened the cage. That is the statement which he gave me. It's very deep. But basically he wanted to say that now you have to fly, do whatever you want to do. So that's why I made a small tribute to Chaya sir. I did my urban design, okay. Coming back to what the SEPT course was. I did my master's in urban design. And in a way everything helped. It's not that I am leaving everything apart. Everything which came in my 7 years of education, everything helped me. The cities, the understanding the cities part was very helpful for me to look at things critically. I mean, even though I loved art, I loved this art of comic making, but I had to be critical about how I think about anything. So the course of urban design taught me through understanding cities that you have to be critical, you have to have your own point of view. In which, you know, this sort of is what my niche is today, architecture and cities. So it's basically comics about architecture and cities, it's not only about architecture. Yeah, I know the comics on architecture get viral because that is the ptinas, that's what you call, right? That's the thing which people want to share more. But I also do comics on cities, which don't get that much viral. But if you go through the feed, you will find a lot of comics there are on urban issues and how cities work. But it was not easy. I was like frustrated, not in terms of... So there's one thing called ki you find your passion. Everybody has a passion, I'm sure. Okay. The second is you have to keep on working on it. I mean, whatever your passion is, you have to keep on working on it. You cannot say, ki, these are the problems, that's why I cannot continue. You can take a pause, but you have to keep on working on it. That's what I felt, even though I was frustrated for a very long time in between, because I thought that the idea of leaverdus was very piecemeal. There's no path. I mean, everything is happening in a piecemeal. For example, the comics which I used to make and I used to put on the social media were not planned. As in, one day I used to talk about issues in the transportation, the public transportation. Other day I used to talk about 10 types of architecture students. So it was not focused. So still, even when I started with all my passion, there was a lot of frustration, trust me. And I used to, luckily through SEPT, I used to attend a lot of workshops, and especially abroad. And I was like, you know, this is the best thing that happened to me, going to foreign. And in a way, I went with the idea of just going for free. Yeah, it was a funded, fully funded workshop. So I was like, the best thing that can happen is travel for free. And trust me, that is what I'm doing right now also. Okay. So these things help me in a way. So I did not consciously decide that traveling will help me or going to these places will help me. But in a way, it worked. And everything which happened, like I said, all these 8-9 years of my education and my practice helped me to decide upon what I want to do. So the abroad thing also helped. And so this is still SEPT. Okay, now I'm still in SEPT. And I graduated from SEPT. And just like everybody else, what do? Job. Yeah. And I was even more frustrated because the professional life is like, if you could see the comics, it is, I mean, there are both ways. The school is frustrated when you are in the school. When you get out, the profession is frustrating. So the profession was frustrating for me because all these ideas which I had in mind, I could not practice them in the office or even in my own practice. Because, like I said, you know, I was expecting this is what I would do, but eventually I was doing this. But my boss was a very cool guy. He was a Dutch guy, and he helped me to understand that you can do. So he's not like, he forgot all that, just focus on this office, you can become an associate. No, nothing like that. He actually motivated me, and eventually he set me free, trust me. Okay. Yeah, he was very happy to set me free. But yeah, he actually said that if you want to leave the office and if you want to start your own thing, you can do it. There's nothing wrong in it. And I'll not have any grudges because I promised him for 2 years and I wanted to leave in 1 year. So he said it's perfectly fine. So I am also grateful to Steven. Like, there are few people in your life who come and do something, right? Like Catalyst. So these are one of the people. So he set me free. And 2014 was actually when I started drawing. So now I'll come to, my love for comics was so immense that I wanted to do it, but I had never practiced, trust me. I mean, these were my only inspirations at that time. I mean, this would be the highest. And because I wanted to study who is the Indian guy who is doing it. So for me, I think Mario Miranda is the only Indian person who is doing it. And these are some of the other people, maybe you can just check them out. Very cool people. Scott McLeod actually has comic books on how to make comics. Brian Lee O'Malley is the person who is, I showed Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. So these are the four people who have inspired me, who were my, teachers in terms of making comics, okay, drawing comics. But I never practiced, that's what I said. Nobody motivated me during, even till SEPT, end of SEPT, nobody told me that you should draw. So after SEPT, I started. So it's not that I've been drawing comics. I've been reading comics from my childhood, but I have not been drawing comics. Because nobody, if I would draw something, somebody would come and say, don't do this. Don't draw. I mean, don't be an artist, kind of a thing. Not my parents, other people. My parents are very cool. Okay, trust me. But he's an architect, so he has that sort of this thing, he's not doing architecture anymore. But I think he's fine now. you know, like, somebody has said that it's never too late to start. So I started drawing comics in 2014. So the first comic which I practiced, I put it on the social media. So it's not like I practiced for a year and then I posted it on my social media. The first comic which I made, I directly put it on social media, but because I thought I was very late in starting this, so I just had to put everything on the social media platform. Why I chose internet? Because I think it's the most, I would not say it's the easiest way to reach people. Trust me, it's the hardest. But if you hit the right notes, it will reach to anywhere in the world. And I think that's why Arc Daily also found out about me making comics. So it's just because of the internet that Arc Daily and a lot of other people know about my work. Trust me, the percentage of international followers is 55%. So it's only India is 45%, rest is out of India. So I think because of the internet, the power of internet, it has reached to all people in the world. Architects, not people, I think. Because that is my first target. And I started. So you know, then you start to look. I started to think critically, okay, now I have to start. I have to make a mark. I started to think about what we as designers do. So we are architects, designers, okay. So we innovate, we design, we build, and we are happy. Okay. Yeah, we are happy, right? No, okay. So with the whole thing in mind, I just thought of this question ki, you know, we are drawing a lot in our profession. We are talking also a lot. And now because now I am an urban designer, urban planner, conservation architect, I draw things which are even more complex. So eventually nobody understands. Okay, I have done a lot of exercises and workshops. Nobody understands our plan. The workshop which I take, the product of the workshop is that you have to show it to your mother. So your mother is your best client. I mean, if she understands your design, then I think you have maybe put it in the right manner. So you have to, so for me, whatever comic I make, I have to keep in mind that my mother will be able to understand. So the common man, the point is, even though it is about the fraternity, but it also talks about architecture and cities, but reaching out to the whole world, not only architects. It's basically trying to break the shell. I'm trying to break the shell, trust me. And it's hard, but there is hope. So we give presentations to authorities, bureaucrats and professionals, right? And that's what we do, jury member, politicians, bureaucrats. Why can't we give presentations to common people? I mean, why can't we do that? So when somebody tells you you have to show your design to the common mass, immediately you go back and you start changing everything, right? That's what even in SEPT, when we were told to show our studio work to the collector and the authorities who don't know anything about the whole city, and later on we had to show it to the public, so we had to be public. So it was difficult for us to use the same plans and sections and show it to the common mass. So basically somewhere the bigger vision is that Leverdist is all about talking about our fraternity, talking about design to the masses. Okay, it's not only about us. So what I did, so where this came, like how did this come into my mind? I used to make a lot of these things when I was in SEPT. So it's like a pedestrianization plan with trees and cars and, you know, a pedestrianization proposal. So what I did was I just took this plan and I showed it to an electrician who came to my house. So this is what he saw: green dots, two lines, brown lines, a gray patch, and he said this, these are switches for him. Okay. So you can imagine, I did not say anything to him ki this is a plan, pedestrianization, transportation, no such thing. I just said ki what do you see, bhaiya aapko kya dikhta hai? And he said these are switches for him. Because he's an electrician, he said AS Roma switches, to be very precise. And I was like, thank you can leave. And then it was more about me understanding that whatever we are drawing, and we are very happy and we are very good with these these big conferences, talking about architecture within ourselves. But if you show these things to the common mass, you will get answers like these. Okay. So it was frustrating. I laughed, of course I laughed. But it was frustrating because I could not communicate. We are a huge community. we are a very prestigious fraternity and we are not able to communicate, which is, I think that's the harsh truth. We are not able to communicate our work. There are people who are trying, but I'm saying in general, we are not. So instead, can there be a comic about pedestrianization or transportation or public transportation? So why can't it be simple? And this idea of me loving comics and then this issue of not communicating came together. And yeah, that's where Levardist came into picture. And the biggest question everybody asks is why the name? Yeah. There are a lot of people who message me on the Instagram page, can you tell me the meaning? And I said, next time when we meet, I'll tell you, because it's very difficult for me to explain in a few words. So whenever we meet, I'll show you the whole PPT. So it's basically the leeward side of the hill. Okay, so the windward side is always the good side, because it has sun, rain and wind. Okay, so it's the greener side, it's the good to look at side. And the leeward side is the bad side, or the not too good. It's the law of nature. I mean, it's not to be blamed. The leeward side is not to be blamed. But somewhere, I think I'm trying to highlight the leeward side of the city or architecture. So leeward side is just a metaphor of trying to highlight the darker issues or the hidden issues of design, architecture, cities, whatever my forte is. So it's basically a leewardist, yeah, thoda sa philosophical, it's a bit philosophical, but I think it's okay because we are architects, we do that, we tend to be complex, and it's okay. A lot of people don't even know how to pronounce, and they're like, I am from leewardist, what? Leewardist, so I have to be a bit vocal, but I think it's okay, it's fine. 3 saal ho gaya, I don't have to change now, then people will apprehend. So I think it's fine that the name is a bit hard to pronounce. So it's basically, then what is the motto of Leeward? So trying to break down the things, so basically I identify an issue, I reach out through a certain kind of method, and then I demonstrate. So what exactly this is, so identify is maybe, you know, identifying any issue about the changing architecture trend. Okay, just an example. And I use my website, my Facebook page and the Instagram page to reach out to the masses. And these are some of the issues which you have maybe seen somewhere. So discrimination towards designer, frustrations of an architect. And then the reaching out is done through these comics, which has a particular method. So the method is that, for example, when you go to a library, which is the book which you pick out? Which has, yeah, more images. That's the harsh truth, but it's fine. So you see, when you see something, even statistically, it's proven that you understand more. But if you laugh, which I think is missing everywhere, if you laugh, you'll remember it for the rest of your life. Trust me. Okay, so there are some sketches which might be there for the rest of your life, which I'll show maybe, if you laugh. So I try to put humor in every comic, but you cannot force humor. It's difficult, trust me. It's very difficult. And when nobody laughs, you feel very sad. Okay. I mean, okay, now you laugh, so I felt better. But when you are on the virtual this thing platform, you don't know if that haha is haha or sarcastic haha or what. So it becomes difficult for you to evaluate, is the humor correct or has it reached to the masses? And the other problem is sarcasm, it doesn't, board time it goes away. And I think it's meant to be that way. It's perfectly fine. The people who get it, they laugh, like they say like, oh, you are the best, yeah, man. They give comments like these, and the rest are like question mark. So it's perfectly fine to have both of them. So then I started to make comics, okay, and I decided my platform, and I thought I'll come up with a formula. Okay, so what is this formula? Because I do one comic word per day. If you have if you follow the Facebook page or the Instagram page, there's one comic almost, I would say, one comic per day. So how do I get these ideas? What is the formula? Basically, I have made a formula for this. The first is, it should be a long-term thing. So, for example, I am talking here and I talk with someone and he says, why don't you make something on this? And I said, okay, yeah, I'll obviously make something on this. And I go back and I make it. But then maybe every time do I have to be dependent on people to give me ideas? So, that was one thing. And the other thing is, I wanted to have a face. Okay, so basically, there are other pages also on Facebook or Instagram who are called, they are called architectural memes or memes, whatever you want to call it. I think it's memes. Yeah. So architectural memes, there are a lot of pages and I think they have bigger followership than me. But I think it was not about just creating a meme and this is a comic. Okay, this is not a meme. There are people messaging me, best memes. I said, star comics. So these are comics, okay. So there are a lot of other pages who also putting content, humorous content mostly, but content about architecture. And I wanted to be different because I had the advantage of drawing something, okay. So I thought I can make a face. So I started scribbling about how this guy will look. So it started from a beard, okay. So this is archived content, okay. So people who are following the page, they might not see all of this. So it started with a beard because I thought, like Neelkan Chaya sir, so I thought, let's have a beard. But then I took a review of a lot of people, including my mom. She said, ki beard nahi achhi lagti, you remove it. So I said, okay, fine. And then I started to think about how will he be when he runs or walks or, so I have to be... whatever he has a Lamy pen. So this was the pre-final sketch. I was almost sure that no, I'll keep a beard. But then I listened to my mom's advice and I said, okay, no, I'll keep a stubble instead. Okay, so it's better. So I'm somewhere in between. It actually has a whole research. The stubble is because they don't have time to shave. But I did not, so I don't get like huge beard, so it's like only a stubble for me. The goggles or the spectacles are more of observation. It's an observation goggle rather than just being spectacles. The brain is divided into two parts. One is the idea generator device and the other is the idea copier device. So you cannot be either of the one, so you have to balance in between. Black, because I think black is everywhere and my surname is also Kale. So I think black was something which I wanted to keep. Also yeah. Also that we are not very formal. We are not suited and booted. And we are not very casual or informal also. So we are somewhere in between where I have a formal shirt and on top of that I have a sweater. So it's somewhere, I don't know, what do you call it? Informal or whatever. So it's somewhere in between. And I have my phone and the camera, like every other architect. The phone is a device used to browse Pinterest and Google new designs. Okay. The laptop device is used for watching movies and sometimes working on AutoCAD. Yeah, it's a sort of a sarcastic guy. So this was the idea of this. Yeah, there are two shoes. One is the site supervision and the other the meeting shoes. So this was the guy which took around 2 months for me to visualize. Yes, I actually left everything. I was as it is doing nothing because I was at such a point that do or die. I have invested like a year and a half on Leverdist and I'm nowhere. And then I thought of taking a break and doing it like patiently. I designed this guy, I took 2 months. And I traveled just to clear off my mind. And then I came back and this guy came into picture in last year only. So it's only been a year since this guy has come. So it's not like this guy was there from 2014. It's just only like a year. In August, this guy came. So the So the guy came into picture. Now the second is, what do I draw about? Okay, so the second formula is, so yeah, urban design is there. It's my mind and my heart is architecture. So I keep on toggling between the two. So urban design plus X is equal to the conic. Okay. The architect or the scenario of architecture plus X is equal to comic. So basically it's all about just putting this X. Okay. Not finding. You can put this X. It can be anything. For example, X is equal to life. So life of an architecture student. Okay. It starts from your ape man and it ends at the drafting table. Okay. Then you work on your design the whole night and then your professor says that it looks like you have made this in 5 minutes. And then it's something like this. Okay, so you don't do like this, but inside you are always like this. So the first year, second, so it's basically the cocoon and then slowly turning into a butterfly and then after graduation. And yeah, this was submitted. So I also take submissions, as in a lot of people who give me ideas. So this was a very good idea, which I thought I wanted to draw this. Yeah, it's sad. I know it's sad. But I mean, life will be sad sometimes. Because I also get this thing that this is too depressing. It's fine. I mean, there are going to be highs and lows, so I think it's fine. Then life, how the life changed before and after architecture, getting into architecture. So basically, before architecture, sleeping was something like this, and after architecture, it came something like this. Important dates, meeting friends and partying. Now it was submissions, deadlines. Weekends is like, let us meet for drinks on the weekend. Now it's like, let us work at my place on the weekend. Commuting. Eating food. And then this. Seeing beautiful things. And here you can. Cutting things. Seeing historical places. So basically, previously you just used to go visit. Now you measure them. Watching a movie. I don't know if somebody has done this. Yeah, that's. I think it's the best way. I mean, it's even if you don't do this, do this. I mean, it's the best way. Just put your VLC media player on the top. It is, and pick a movie which you're not interested or you have seen once. Okay. It's there. It's there in your vision. You don't see it. You work on your thing and you understand the movie, that's for sure. So it's a very good way of doing both the things together. And the best is asking for favors. Before architecture, it was, can you give your bike for a month? Now it is like, can you design for free? So yeah, things have changed after architecture. So now we'll take X is equal to jealousy. Any word, I think it can be anything. The formula is very simple. You just have to put this word. So when it is your design, this design is an affair with slits, minimalistic yet romances with the volume and form of the building. One of my many standouts. When it is others, same thing, okay? What is this, a box? It looks like there is no design. And what are the use of those slits? You want the user to stay in dark forever. And the best is, I have already seen this on the internet. And this, okay, so jealousy. So any word, so it's basically easier. So I've made my comic making thing easier because I think it's mostly about 80% of the idea and only 20% of the artwork. Trust me, it's that. Honest. Okay, let's take X is equal to honest. The most honest architectural 3D view. So it's honest, it's sarcastically honest, it's not honest. I will never ever see this sky color in my life. This void will never be built. Vegetation to cover the ugliness of the building. Trees that never grow in your city, but who cares, they look good. Ducks. Lake with the bluest water, black colored gutter in reality. Foreigners who will never reside in the building. Swimming pool that will not be maintained and have no water a year later. How did the Swiss Alps come to my country? Migrating birds in the wrong direction. So, honest, okay? Honest. Honest as in like brutally honest. Like AIB. Okay? Then I made an honest resume. Okay? So, the career objective is to work with your firm because I'm jobless right now. But will leave your office within a year because I do that with every office. Qualification is like 10th standard, 12th standard, second class in Bachelor's of Architecture. Please don't judge me on this. Proficiency, the highest is lying about my proficiency. Skills, PowerPoint and Microsoft Word are the highest. Professional experience, very, very small firm, private limited. Made toilet drawings and checked previous drawings for most of the time. Made good tea for my boss. Okay. The second is a little better firm, private limited. Still made toilet drawings because you cannot escape it. Worked on PowerPoint presentations and some 3D SketchUp work. Did not make tea for boss this time. Affiliations. Sorry. it's a joke. Okay. I think this is the... It's a... professional forum. I forgot. So, okay, so basically affiliations which don't even, make a difference. So I just forgot that I have come for a professional this thing. Because I think, okay, forget it. Recognitions, got first prize in cricket championship office. Got consolation prize in annual NASA in a stone throwing event. Okay, so this is the recognition which I have got. Academic projects, my first year basic design project which will be so helpful to your firm. My thesis project which is so bad that I'm sure you'll reject me, but I don't have anything better than this. My other office work which I didn't even work on. I cannot put the toilet drawing in this, come on. I hereby declare that the above given information is not 100% true to my knowledge, which you will come to know once I join the office. So this was the honest guy. So he's honest also at times. Just a quick discussion. So, see, basically, people say that, yeah, I make fun. I add humor. But I think it's more about understanding how not to do a resume. So, instead of other platforms writing about how to do a resume, this would hit the audience in a bigger level because this says how not to do and with a hint of humor. So, trust me, I am also trying to educate. It's not only about being, like, talking about the humor side of architecture, it's also about learning. The rendering view is a problem, not only with the real estate developers, but also in the student fraternity also, that we are very fascinated with these images. So trust me, you have to find the answer as in the learnings. You have to find it yourself. I don't have to spoon feed ki iska conclusion is something blah, blah, blah. You have to find it yourself. Trust me, every comic has. Trust me, if you look into it, there is a conclusion which you have to find out. So the honest series is trying to put the honest side of the profession and learning from it. Okay. Honest bungalow design. Circle, triangle, because I learned basic design in my college. Colors, the client will love a different color, of course he will. Inclined wall, pergola, neglected compound wall design. Bad grill design, because I don't have time to think on a good design. Landscaping, this helps me in hiding my ridiculous design. Not so fancy lamps. Huge glass window because I saw this in Europe. Expensive cladding because my client has money. Slope because I need a traditional element in my design. So this again is trying to show the honest side, but I think there is a learning also, trust me. If you try to look at it in that way. Honest site analysis. Water flowing through the site which is actually dry. I like to use different colors to make my sheet look vibrant. Trees which I will promise to keep but won't. Curvy blue arrows, which we also call wind direction. See, this is something which I did. Okay, I'm not escaping that I did not do this. I did this. Sun path, okay? Yeah? The sun moves from east to west. Yes, everybody knows that. Okay, so everybody did this. I also did this. Okay. So, honest site analysis. Now let's take x is equal to expectation. We expect a lot of things, right? What I expected after becoming an architect, my son is a great architect. Wow, what a designer. Can you work for me? My friend is a great designer. He is so cute, plus he is an architect. I always wanted to meet him. Okay, this was my expectation. And what I got was, material has not arrived yet. What about the payment? Column beam position not correct. When are you sending the drawing? Can you change the door color? And yeah, you cannot escape that. So this is what I got. First year, second year, third year, fourth year, fifth year. After. Okay, so this has been copied by a lot of pages. This is my original sketch, okay. Hundreds of pages have made a different version of this, but with the same thing. This is my patent, okay. And people are sending me, "Arey sir, ye banao na." Maine bola banaya hai. So, a very special one. But I think this is, yeah, so I think you have seen this, sir. Yeah. So I think that's what I was trying to say, that even though my sketches are not being, it is not reached to the maximum amount, but in a way, there are sketches which have reached, and they have broken the boundaries, and they have gone beyond. And this is one of the sketches which has actually gone beyond the fraternity. And I think it's very simple. It's not a difficult sketch. It's like, and just to show you something, I always have an inside joke. Okay, so the inside joke over here is, although the design is changing, the tree also is changed, getting smaller. Okay. So, bonsai, yeah, it's like bonsai. So, but that's expensive. So, I think this was the sketch which took me from, I would say, like 10,000 people on the social media platform to right now 85,000 people in total. Because this actually reached out to not only architects but to non-architects also. There were friends who were sending me, "Yaar, tera sketch hamare group pe hai." Maine kaha, "Tu architect hai kya?" "Nahi, main nahi hu." So that was a big achievement. That because this talks about not only about architecture, I think it is every profession. The medium is architecture. That's what I would say, because this was also shared by non-architectural groups, because this is the process which everybody faces, irrespective of what field that is. So yeah, it's a very special, not my best though, but it's a special thing because it has taken me in terms of numbers, okay? Everybody evaluates in terms of numbers, how many likes you have, shares and all that. So yeah, this is the sketch. Trust me, it took me 10 minutes to make this. So it's not that the amount of time invested on a sketch is equal to the number of popularity. It can happen anywhere, even on your toilet seat. But yeah, did this not happen in a toilet seat. This was just me after having a good breakfast, you know. So this is a very special sketch, so I took some time to show you this. What you think and what you put on paper. When your professor drops your model by accident, and you have to smile and pretend you don't kill them right now. Some of the things which I have faced, okay, so. He's alive. He's not dead. So we'll take X is equal to client. Okay. So I think everybody is in the profession right now. Yeah? Okay, kind of. So when you work on something, you know, like the whole night, and you show it to the client and he's like, "I'm really disappointed, is this the best you got?" You go back, you just add an inclined wall and he says, "Wow, this is so nice, you're like the best designer." So, sarcasm. Architectural conferences, when you go, this is your expectation that, wow, interesting works, and in reality you're waiting for the food and drinks. So this is actually me standing there actually now. And inside jokes, hey, okay. And the other is, my work that nobody is interested in seeing. Yeah, thoda. I should have not put this. X is equal to latest trends. So trend doesn't anything. So now, like yesterday only, one of the vocalist of Linkin Park died. So I'm making something on that. But with architecture, of course. So it's not only. So you have to fuse. You cannot only talk about your profession. I mean, I'm talking about my profession in a simpler format, but I think I also do this experimentation where I put the architect in anything which is happening. Anything. So like mobile applications. Okay. WhatsApp, the app which allows me to be in touch with other humans while I'm working. The most trusted source of information. Can you tell me what this is? So you are using that. Okay, good. So this is the most trusted source of, yeah, information. Yeah, sarcasm. YouTube, use it to watch funny videos when I have a big submission deadline tomorrow. Okay, so trying to put the architect into mobile applications. Then demonetization happened, right? And have you seen this?
No.
So archived, okay. Thoda. So then I thought ki if an architect would design a 2000 rupee note for architects, okay, then what would it look like? So basically, yeah, the architect. So yeah, so COA registration number. And it's all about architecture, the plans and the north symbol, the Corbusier's hand. So it's a big thing. So maybe when you, I don't know, maybe I'll not send it to you, but you can check it out. It's a very detailed thing. Swachh Bharat is out now. It's Design Bharat. Ek Kadam Design Ki Or, because we need to design, right? These are like columns and brackets and beam details, which are there in the listing. And yeah, what an architect would think, I mean, we can debate on it, but yeah, you know, this is the 2000 rupee note for architects by an architect, which is of no use, okay. Then New Year resolutions, okay. So the best resolution, what I feel is, I will not let people call me architecture. And I will not cry if I'm called on a holiday, no free design. Okay, so trying to put the architect's resolution into picture, New Year resolution. Designer's vision and after structural changes. iPhone 7 came last year, so I thought I'll make something. So this client is boasting about his phone and he says, "Dekh kitna mehenga phone, look at my phone." And then he says, "Sir, my fees is pending." "Oh, did I say iPhone 7? I said I'll phone you at 7. Okay, bye." So he can buy an iPhone 7, but when he wants to give my payment, he doesn't want to. I don't know what. And I have faced this, okay. Sometimes he becomes a superhero. So trying to be as, you know, soch ke dekhte, let's think. You know, I just don't scrap out ideas. I just say, let's put it out. So I thought I'll make a superhero. If architect becomes a superhero, so yeah, he's useless superhero actually. Helps in drawing parallel lines. Expensive pen to make other architects jealous. Utility belt contains eraser, ink pen, cutter and measuring tape. Underwear because Superman wears it too, of course. Cape of shame can hide in this when a client asks for refund. Critique and jury proof shield, also used to draw circus. A lame superhero. I mean, actually the story behind this, I was just drawing about this superhero. I was trying to understand anatomy. So I thought, you know, these superheroes like Superman and Batman, I thought I'll try to trace them. And I eventually made this. Dekhte kya hota hai. Nahi chala, flop ho gaya. That's why it's not in your minds, okay. Then he celebrates Christmas. So he says, Santa Claus says, "What do you want?" He says, "I want an Apple MacBook." "What, are you mad? Ask something that I can give you." He says, "I want a job where I get the freedom to design and top of that I get a good salary." "So which MacBook do you want, Air or Pro?" Yeah, sad. But I think trying to put him in every day, I mean, he's celebrating Christmas, but he cannot. How others tell an address and how we tell, I mean, I as in we tell an address. How others see the map of India. Okay, and how architects see the map of India. It's good. Yeah, we do it by the architectural style or the architectural identity. Yes, I know a lot of debate can happen on this, but I think we can keep that for the social media. X is equal to critically, okay. So not everything is funny, okay. So there are some serious comics also. So this is one of the sketches which again went beyond the fraternity. So it's all about identity, which can also be architecture, it can also be other things also. So this is something which is like a mockery that everything is same. Okay. And I think because it was visually simple, I think it reached out to a lot of audience. This is one of the sketches which is more interpretative. I think it is not about me telling you what it is. In fact, I would want you to tell me, what do you see here? Anything. So I'm allowed to like interact also. Khushru?
Yeah.
Chalega na, no problem. So can you tell me? I want to hear it because I think it is left halfway, because I think more is upon the user to say something or critique on it. Anything?
It's the user or the activity or the things that you would include by designing.
Okay, one is that. Okay. So it's basically, maybe we don't include the user sometimes.
We picturize this and design.
Yeah, we design this and we don't picturize this. Okay, one. Anything?
There are a lot of additions like awnings and.
Yeah. So maybe one part is us, one part job is this, and the other part is the user. It can be that also. Our job is maybe up till this. So we don't have to design this for them. I mean, we don't have to say, you put your this thing on that. So it's one part us and then the second part is them. Maybe. I'm just, this is my vision. I think anything else. Somebody said chaos. Yeah. Okay. I mean, it's up to the user. Anything else?
No. I think as architects, we love this pristine building. And then actually, that's what it turns out.
To
anybody to touch our building.
Yeah. I think that's true. I think this would have been removed. Maybe it would have, but it had a good discussion on the portal. But yeah, I think somewhere this is also close. So it's, I think you cannot say what is like right and wrong. It is whatever the user wants to see.
The architects very often forget to provide place to dry clothes, and from the building.
So, moving on to X again, X is equal to frustration, okay. So, what frustrates an architect? The builder questioning your talent, your boss taunts you about your qualification, didn't they teach you anything in college? Your laborer blames you for his mistake, this cloud was given in the drawing. When your client questions your fees, this is too high, our engineer makes a plan for 2000 rupees. I don't know. Yeah, nobody laughed, because trust me, this is very common in second tier, third tier, second tier maybe, this, it's very prominent, and I have my colleagues who are in Nasik, and this is what they say, ki our engineer can make a plan. So it's a harsh reality out there, which is something like this. When the client's wife thinks she's more creative than you, a pink bathtub will look good. Wow, Sunita, you are so creative. And when the client comes up with absurd demands, I want a bungalow like this, which I saw in Antarctica. When some jealous architects are always degrading your work, he has copied this design from that magazine. Yeah. And when your client thinks his carpenter is an interior designer. Our carpenter can also do interior designing. And so this is like the Dragon Ball Z character, which I eventually made. And the worst is fighting between, like within yourself. Okay. So you want to decide what is good, I mean sustainable. Do you want to work towards these or these? So I think the biggest frustration is in within your mind. So all those who are in college. Okay. So yeah, it can be changed to, do I work for the submission, for the deadline, or do I actually take time and work on the design? Okay. So, hey. What everyone says about architects, the first is, history says something good, like we are chief builders, okay, yeah, architecton. Google says that an architect is someone who plans, designs, a good way of defining, I would say. Then laborers on my, I'm not pretty sure, like they think you are a genius, is that true? I mean, they think that, haan, sabko aata hai sab. My friends are creative people. Huh? And somebody is at the back saying, I heard they don't get paid. True. Government is not there to answer my question. The real estate developer thinks he is my slave. The client thinks he makes plans, Naksha, and that too very cheap. My father said, not my father, I mean in general, I wanted him to become an engineer. Oh, I thought architect and engineer are the same. My grandfather said that I used to build my own house, I don't need an architect. My maid is not interested because she wants a payment. And the best is my mom. Yeah. So mom is a very important part of my life because she is always talking wrong about architecture. Because I am an architecture for it. Okay. So X is equal to looking at buildings. So architect visits Taj Mahal. How common people see Taj Mahal? How couples see Taj Mahal? How stereotype tourists see Taj Mahal? And how architects see Taj Mahal? So it's not only Taj Mahal, it's every building, everything which we see is something like this. So you have these words coming, symmetry. So I also wanted to do a lot of animations, but the problem is that animations take a lot of time. But this, trust me, it takes no time to make this for me. So the architect, teachers in the architecture school. The first is the virus from 3 dates. Get out, you are late. Sir, I'm just 1 second late. The questioning professor, I don't know if this kind of exists. There are teachers who just come and start asking questions and everybody's trying to ignore that question. Of course, the sensible professor dedicated to Neelkanth Chaya. The friendly professor, which you can find a lot these days. Okay, he can discuss your design over a cup of tea, maybe on the canteen. The never-ending discussion professor, it's 11 o'clock in the night. Sir, I understood, can we go? It is almost midnight. The dictionary professor, so this is again somebody who I was very afraid of. Can anybody try to say like who this person is? Hey, he's from SEPT. Yes. So Rameshwar, I was in the blacklist of the 20 students which were there in the urban design course. So I was in the bottom 3. So kuch bhi ho gaya, Anuj, Saurav and Soham are the one who were making the problems. So, and he used to talk like this, and I used to say to my friend, ki kya bola yaar? Kya, what, which language? And I showed it to Rameshwar also. So it's done. So it's not like this is a secret. I showed it to him also. And he said, hey, I never used to do this. Well, okay. And the best teacher. So you have faced it, I mean the people who are studying right now. I think we need one person at least in a studio who is something. I think a lot of the students got scared actually. So they did not laugh because they got scared. I mean maybe they remembered their like taja taja zakham, we bolte na usko. And I used to get a lot of these. I think SEPT was more into this. They wanted to just tear everything. So I think the terror is the, you need to face this once. Okay, so tree, I mean just a word, random. Okay, but when I show you the word, you say ki what? I mean how can this be a comic? Right, I mean tree. If I put the word tree in the X, what can it be? How an architect sees a tree? How a common man sees a tree? A same narrative which I used for Taj Mahal comic. Nice big tree. How children see a tree? Wow, a tree. How activists see a tree? They want to save the tree. How real estate developers see a tree? They don't see a tree actually. How a woodcutter sees a tree? And how an architect sees a tree? So, no dialogues, no nothing. It's, I think the answer is the visual itself. So we design. We should be designing according to the tree or nature in a bigger vision. So I educate also. I at least try to. Anything, again, something which is trending or something which is an issue, for example. Okay. So this was actually not made for the not after the demolishing. It was made when the announcement of demolition happened, which was I think 10 months or I think 8 to 10 months back. So it's not that ki phut gaya aur maine banaya, aisa nahi hai. It is because I'll tell you. So this is basically a premise where the architect takes a bunch of kids to show them what Pragati Maidan is, and he asks them ki when was this built, and they are like 2 years, 6 months, yesterday. Okay. No, it was built in the 1970s, and it's like, oh wow, but it looks so hip. So every panel is trying to say something. If you try to look at it from that perspective, every panel is trying to say something. He then talks about who are the people behind it, what is the structural system all about, what is the volume of the whole thing, how is the plan form derived, what is the pattern. I mean, he takes out the phone, he opens Wikipedia, of course, the most trusted source, and then he shows ki it's a replication of the Jali pattern, and how it is humane. I mean, instead of a box, it's more humane, the form, and overall it is a symbol of heritage, and it becomes an identity of modern Indian architecture. But something is going wrong here. This guy says, sir, what is this board here saying? He sees the board and he faints. Yeah, sad. So this was attempted by me to maybe create some kind of awareness, and to some extent it did, because it was shared by Chitra Vishwanath, Nimish Patel, Arun Rewal. So maybe it reached to that mass. So I was like, okay, theek hai. Even if it reached to that mass, that layer, so I was pretty happy ki theek hai, I am contributing maybe 1% to that whole thing. But eventually it did not survive. Then I talked about how architecture urban design can be a part of women's safety. So it's a small comic. I mean, we can discuss on it, but I think it's more about actually telling people that there is a field called urban design also through the issue of women's safety. So basically, I just quickly, it's a lot of text. So it's basically trying to show the scenario of this girl standing in an old city, and maybe some thoughts which are happening behind her back. So this is basically the old city. Yeah, I'm not good with words, so this was written by somebody else. So I am not very good with words. I try to avoid words, because I think if there are words, then I maybe consult somebody. So it's basically the old city, the neighborhood, the corporate jungles, the gated communities. You can see the contrast. The most safest township in India. Women safe houses at only 50,000 rupees per square feet. The city periphery. So basically, just trying to, there's no conclusion to this. So it's basically trying to talk about that urban design can also play an important role in actually making feel women safer. So a small attempt. I know there are a lot of, it can be a debate altogether, but this was an attempt which I made. Then the idea of the not so smart cities is a very recent one. So when I was a kid, so it's not what you're expecting, okay? Something very, very, maybe very crazy, and maybe it makes no sense in the end, but I think I'll just give it an attempt to tell people what smart means. So when I was a kid, this is a true story, okay? So nothing is made up. Basically, this guy is me without the long hair, okay? Long hair, abhi, this is a recent thing. It's my story. This guy is me. I'm telling my story this with the face of this guy who is an architect. And I was sent forcefully to the NCC camp because of reasons. And he thought that I'll learn very new things and I'll be a better person and better, less mischievous, and you know, all those things. And he said that you'll learn new things in life. And I said, oh, I hope. And he says, how many new things I have to learn every year? So as the camp started, I was told to take care of the, not vegetables, but thoda flowers and, you know, small vegetables. It was a big campus, which is in Nasik. It's called Bhosla Military School. So you can use the bicycle for your transportation. I learned techniques to conserve the water, I mean, natural resources. I led a group of cadets. Yeah, this is a lie. But generally, yeah, the idea of leadership came into picture. And we built our own house. I mean, wherever we used to go, we used to build our own house, a temporary one. And I started caring about nature more than before. And I was happy. Yeah, I used to miss my parents, but I was happy. And when I returned, everybody said, "Are smart, you are smart, you have become smart." Everybody used to say, "You, the things which I did there," based on that, my father at least said, "Yeah, are smart ho gaya, Anuj." And I was happy. But now that I'm an architect, okay, and when I see this news about 100 smart cities, I thought this is not the smart which I was told 15, 20 years back. So the smart has, the definition has changed. I want a city with metro, smart homes, iPad homes, CCTV everywhere, free Wi-Fi, and everything other thing that a smartphone offers. But sir, this is a city, not a smartphone. Shut up and do as I say. And this definitely was not my definition of smart. I want a smart city where the city is smart enough to take care of itself in terms of all the things which I did when I was in the NCC camp. That is what a smart city for me, or in general, is. So this is a way of at least talking about the word smart. Forget smart cities. And it's very difficult for these topics to get into the fraternity and then maybe going out. But, theek hai, I will keep on doing these kind also. And this will increase. So the humor will be there, but I think this will be more in future. So this is one of the ways of looking at latest issues and trends. Case studies, right? We are doing... students. So we are doing case studies, right? So everybody has done. In fact, in the profession also we are doing. I'll just take a moment. Akushru, time. Okay, theek hai. I'll then quickly go. So case study. So I did a comic case study where I took Sabarmati as a case study and how to explain it through this comic. So basically his niece wants to go to some mall and she cannot because the architect has forced her to say ki, let's go to Sabarmati Ashram, and he is very excited, but she is not. And then eventually he starts to talk about the architecture of that place and how the village layout and how it's so quiet that people, students come there to actually read. And then he talks about in depth about the place, and then he says ki, let's go, I will not take more of your time. And then she is sitting somewhere close to the water body and she says, "Uncle, did architect meet Gandhiji?" He says, "No." Then how did he create such a space where everybody can feel his presence and get a glimpse of his life just by visiting the ashram? I guess that is where the importance of an architect and the value of good architecture comes into picture. It has the power to transport people into a different zone even after years of construction. Then she says, "Uncle, can we stay here a bit longer?" He says, "We can stay as much as you want." A fictional story, but talking about architecture and how, including people who are not from the architecture field. I'll move quickly. X is equal to crazy. Superheroes, okay. If superheroes had architecture and construction jobs, Superman would be a human crane. Spider-Man would be the waterproofing consultant. I hate my job. Hulk and Thor would be demolition experts. Not a very known character, but she has the power of creating trees, and also obviously she becomes a landscape architect. Care for some, yeah, this is Mangifera indica for your backyard. Iron Man is a structural consultant because the pun iron. Green Lantern, a very lame this thing, but he visualizes through his ring, so he becomes a 3D visualizer. Captain America, this shield is my weapon. This is tougher than fighting crime. So he's the labor. Malab, degrade. If Captain America or the guy who played, he sees this, he'll be like, ban karo iska page. Wolverine obviously becomes the model maker. I think I need to change the blade. And Joker becomes the client. And Batman is the architect. Can I tell you a joke? Yeah, tell me. I'll give you your full payment. So again, crazy things, no sense. I started to imagine these master plans which we see, okay, we make. Okay, let's look at them differently. Any random, I just picked out. I have credited them on the page, maybe not here. This is an Indian master plan. Yeah. What is this? I mean, just guess. Anything? Guess. No sense, but aise kar raha, I just do it. This, anything? Yeah. Again, weird. Architect goes to buy a Ganesh idol. Kya samjhega isse? I mean, I know a lot of people like, what is a relation with an architect buying a Ganesh idol? But this comic was shared by non-architectural portals to tell people what an architect is. So it's an interesting story. We can make a documentary also on this if somebody is there to fund the documentary. So this guy goes to buy. He goes to buy the POP first. And then he starts thinking ki POP idols are not good. It is hazardous and it harms the aquatic life. And he's depressed or he's afraid. Then he decides he'll not buy the POP idol. He'll go for a clay idol. He tries to bargain. Then he says ki clay idols are more environmentally friendly and, you know, I think I should go for them. And he goes to buy and he says 1,000 rupees. And, okay. And then the only option he has, make his own idol. So the three things which the article which published said, architect is environmentally responsible, he is creative, and he is underpaid. So architect goes to buy Ganesh idol. Architect who just graduated, I just put it yesterday, so I think, is this a design? This is not your college project. Mothers are like, can you take on off this Saturday? Employers are like, we are only hiring freshers with 3 years of experience, 5 gold medals, and 2 completed bungalow projects. Okay. Neighbors are like, your son finished architecture, can he come and see your leakage problem? And he's reading neighborhood planning here. And fathers are like, no increment again. Sharmaji's son is earning 5 times more in an IT firm. So Sharmaji's son is always there, everywhere. Master's admission is like, you should apply next year. Moms to their daughters be like, okay, you got your degree. We have shortlisted some guys for marriage. Yeah, koi nahi has raha hai, but this is truth. Okay. Again, a different topic altogether. Relatives are like, when will we see your design? Well, sir, it's only been a year. Let me work on it. So it's like you graduated from architecture and where is your design? Kaha hai, building ka hai? And my father again be like, after 5 years of architecture, you want to study 2 more years? I'm like, yes, I want to. X is equal to woman. So yeah, because a lot of requests. There were complaints also and requests also. Complaints were that ki it's male oriented. Okay, I agree. Because I never got the chance to learn. So the anatomy which I learned is something which I, whatever, like seeing myself in the mirror or, you know, so I did not learn how to make comics, or I did not learn anatomy. So then I started to draw anatomy of a woman, and then I came up with this. You are done with architecture, right? Yes. So you are going to get married now. I will be practicing as an architect just like every other architect. Okay. So I'm starting this series, and this girl is also now in some of the comics. They both are coming together. But I'm looking for more topics in this field. If there is something, you can please tell me. X is equal to doctor. Again, doctor? Why are you mixing two professions? So the architect visits the doctor. I wonder how it will go. Okay, son, what is the problem? I think I'm going to die, first thing. Okay, son, let me do a checkup. The first thing which he sees is, your eyes are red and I can see the AutoCAD symbol in your eyeball. Too much of clicking. Your fingers have swollen like a golf ball. Reduce the clicking, my friend. Your x-ray shows Maggie. and your liver is full of coffee. Your heart is not going dhak dhak, it is saying deadline, deadline.
Bad joke.
Don't laugh, please. And you are saying something about headache. Yeah, my clients are eating my head, blah, blah, blah. So he says, I think you are suffering from AutoCAD hypersynthia, client psychosis, abdominal Maggie syndrome, and creativity immune deficiency. Nothing like this exists, but this is trying to talk about how we are. I mean, what is the life of an architect? But why this comic is, I think, the last, no, not the last, but yeah, why it is here, because it has an anticlimax. So this, it does not stop there. It goes and he says, best medicine is 1 week off. He says, oh, I feel better already. Next day, another patient comes. What is the problem? I have my own architectural firm and I think I'm going to die. My employee has taken a week off and there is a lot of work. So this is like a small movie. But because I don't have the funds to make a movie, I make comics. So it's more about script, writing a script. Just like a movie, whatever the graphics is, even if I draw stick figures, it will go, it will reach out only on the basis of the content. Okay, so content is the king, that's what I always say in my mind. And I think this is one of the comics which, yes, I know it is seen by every student, but we'll just see them once again and we'll identify who is who. So the first is the all-rounder student. The best thing about him is he always takes a bath. Okay. And the other things, of course. The always has help student. He always has help. And you can look at his work to be done, inking done, rendering done, model done, bring food also done. And all of these were my classmates. Okay, so I will not name them. The extracurricular student who is not doing architecture but doing everything else. Like me? No. No, I used to do design. The always absent student, who is always absent. The running for marks student. This is the 10th time you have come to show me your sheets. You will not get extra marks. And look, he's shameless guy. The idea stealer. Look at him stealing. Look at him. The geek who is always there for all the lectures and presentations. The full attendance student, she got an award for full attendance. Sir, should I take the attendance even though there is no one in the class? The always questioning student who asks question on the last minute of the lecture. And people getting irritated and speaking. And the most controversial student. So the all-time high, I mean, whatever. Then looking at same students, but then versus now. I mean, then as in maybe your then, and now maybe our now, okay? So drafting then, now, just focus on this panel, okay? Rendering views, sheet composition, submissions, okay, maybe abhi hota hai aisa, theek hai. Lectures, GT, then, now. Discussing with professor. Making models. Concept drawings. Sleeping in class. So, okay, sleeping in class, I think, it's still everywhere, it's the same now also. Controversy. I showed you one, the all-time high, controversial. I'll show you one more. So, the architect's pyramid. So, yeah, it's controversial one, so you can understand. So, the star architect, the overrated architect, the midlife crisis architects, what am I doing? The struggling fresher architect, okay, kill me, and the intern. Yeah, it's very, very bad. But I don't know, maybe it's the truth. So what happened was, people have actually printed this out and put it in their offices. And including Bibi Doshi's office also. वहाँ से somebody told me कि अरे तेरा poster लगाया इधर. मैं बोला बोल मत, दिवाड़ी किसका है. Then I think yeah, we're almost done. So I'll just show you some of the. So this was what I do. I mean, these are the sketches, these are the comics, whatever, not memes. Okay, these are sketches. You can call them sketches, you can call them comics. I also do something like on hand also. A lot of things on hand, because everything else is digitally drawn. Not that there is a formula ki enter kiya to there is a digitally image coming up. These are also drawn by hand, but on an iPad or on a Wacom a tablet, graphic tablet. But there are some sketches which I thought I'll just share. So basically, she is thinking about me and I am thinking about design. And she's the woman architect which is also introduced now. So this is drawn on the paper, not using any hi-fi pens or pencils. It's just a micro tip. I've used two micro tips. One is a 0.5 and a 0.1. That's it. Then I travel. So I went to Gokarna. So I just sketched in my own style with the character in it. Again in Gokarna. If you have seen Narcos, then it's a very bad pun. Narcos, the architect who smuggles design. One of the most, he would get very, like, he would easily get caught. Architect in Goa. I so love this building. And when I travel with my friend Soham, who's from Kolkata, and we usually make it a point that we come and meet maybe every 3 months, we try to, and I made a character of him also, so he's also there sometimes. So all my friends who support me and who are with me, I make characters of them. So this is Soham Deep, and I just drew like some of the stories includes this guy also. Happy New Year, architect. And coming to like you already mentioned that I take workshops. So basically I have tried to use this power of comics, animations and movies. So there's this thing called storyboarding, which I also do a lot in my comics. So I storyboard everything, I have to. So how can storyboarding help students or anybody to present their work in a more, I would say it is more of storytelling rather than telling them how to draw. It's not a drawing exercise, or it's not a drawing workshop. It's more about how to use storyboarding in your presentation. So I do a lot of workshops and we usually make comics because I don't want them to make their design ke presentation. So we make comics so that it becomes a very fun experience for all the students. So these are some of the, it's not clear, but yeah, this is something which the students have made. And yes, I am starting with the merchandise. Yeah, so still in process. It is aimed for the young crowd. I mean, it is, where is the north? Yeah, there's a t-shirt coming up. Where is the north? So it's coming soon. I get a lot of sponsorships, as in people want, because I have the reach, people want me to promote their software or an architectural competition or some issue or even in magazines. So yes, I am earning also out of it. Okay, so it's basically you create a brand. So I have created, I waited for 2.5 years. I am giving it for free, even now it is for free, like for you to look at. But the idea is that the character and the storytelling, it becomes an identity, and that's why people are coming in huge numbers to the page. And there are a lot of people who want to associate in sponsorships. Trust me, everything is good. I just don't say yes to everybody. Okay. So ArchiCAD I did because it's a good software which people can use. So I am doing a promotional event for them. So I'm making comics for them. I'm making competition comics for this competition. This is also a competition which I'm doing. And a lot of magazines also cover my comics. So it's paid. They cannot put it like directly on the magazine. So all this is from Nepal. So Spaces magazine from Nepal is actually publishing my cartoons every month. So it is also a business model. It's just not a hobby. It is not a side thing. Trust me, if it would have been a side thing, I would not have been standing here. It is a full-time thing, and it is churning out money also. Because I am alone, yeah, it's only one guy. There's no team. Were you expecting a team? Yeah, there's no team. It's only me, and that is why I think it is sustainable. Because it's just one person. And it is sustainable, trust me. Now I enjoy even more because there is bonus money coming out from anywhere. So, yeah, and of course. So I am also the official content partner for Aaj Daily, wherein they pick for like two comics every month. The next one which is coming is How an Architect Does Yoga Poses. Okay. Architect Does Yoga Poses. So that is going to come maybe in the next week. Yes. Okay, I mean, I would like to boast. I know there is no guarantee of social media. Yeah, there is no. See, trust me, there is no guarantee. All the social media platforms work very differently. Trust me, I have become like a social media expert also through these 2.5 years. I actually guide also the graphics art company and all the other competitions. I guide them ki what kind of content you need to put on social media. Because social media is not like a print media. People come there just to have fun. They don't want to invest a lot of time reading serious stuff. They just want to enjoy and go back. And they don't have reading time. They don't have time to read. So I also guide, I charge, of course. So I guide other architectural platforms also in terms of how to use social media for their own benefit. And in return, I also create content for them. So I also create content for other social media related to architecture. So architecture is the baseline. Yeah, 85,000 plus, and maybe it will grow soon. I have been also featured in Magic Bricks, Logical Indian, if you know. It's India Times, Men's XP, Scoop Whoop. LA Decor Italia also published my... They published an article on me, on the organization, Levadis, with the title, Looking at the World Through an Architect's Eye. And they themselves wrote everything just by looking at the work. So I think that was one of the best written articles on Levadis without, I think, asking anything, right? He just messaged me on the Facebook page saying, can you send me these images? I am writing an article on you. And I just sent them, and he wrote with the title, Looking at the World Through an Architect's Eye. And I think, just before finishing, last comic. Meet my nephew. Hi. He is an engineer. Uncle, I am an architect. Oh, I'm sorry. Meet my nephew. He is an architectural engineer. So I think that closes. Yes. So, this is again that same Somdeep who I was talking about. He's my classmate, so I put them here.